Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Norah Jones. And we are going to react to the song It Came Upon a Midnight Clear.
So first time single take honest reaction to this song. Merry Christmas and happy holidays to you. This request is part of our Christmas Fest 2020, where we are taking up few of the hundreds of requests we've received over the last 3 years from family, friends, viewers, subscribers, and of course patrons. Yeah, it's been an amazing year for Kriti and me, our family too, as far as reactors, making reactions on YouTube. It's been the best year on this platform for us. It's been the best year in my life personally. I've grown by leaps and bounds, understanding lots of things about humanity, about life in general this year. Thanks to the remarkable amount of free time, extra free time I've had. It's been amazing. And also a lot of extra time that I had to put in my counseling career. So this has been a great year for me. It's been a great year for Kirti and me as well as the kids, because we've really grown by leaps and bounds as a family too. So it's a very special Christmas this year that we are celebrating with you, because it's a special time of our lives. Mm-hmm. 2020, Christmas 2020. People are celebrating it with lot of pompous, lot of, ferocious energy.
I know, that is
Christmas,
the right
while
word.
I'm
ferocious
talking,
energy.
People are bursting crackers. Already it's Christmas Eve. People are enjoying it in Mumbai and most parts of India. We are a small minority in this country, but we are never made to feel that way. That's the beauty of living in India. It's so different from the West, where every single day you're made to feel that you're black, you're made to feel you're Hindu,
I know.
You're made to feel you're Caucasian, you're made to feel you're this and that. In this country, it's wow. Everyone celebrates Christmas with so much energy and vitality, and same goes for Diwali and other festivals that other communities celebrate. Wow, it's the best time to be alive. Norah Jones, it came upon a midnight clear. Maybe if you have time, Kirti, as a Hindu in this part of the world, right, how do you see Christmas? How do you celebrate Christmas? Not just now, but even before you met me, before we got married. What are your thoughts as a Hindu today as well as yesterday? All your thoughts on Christmas. Maybe you can share it in this reaction, or if you have time in another reaction.
When I started watching Hollywood movies and listening to so much music from the West, I realized that Christmas holds some other meaning in the West altogether now.
What is that meaning? What is the difference between
Indian Christmas or the way we viewed it? We have very clear concepts of festivals in Hinduism, and we keep it very strictly. Basics have to be basics. We don't fiddle around with it. We are not there to play with it. Not there to excessively commercialize it. Though in Hinduism, every single festival will involve every person of the society somewhere or the other that they benefit. So all the rituals were designed, at least when they were designed in those stratas of society, everybody was kept in that loop.
Busy, yeah,
so
occupied.
That everybody would benefit. Even for Christmas, I've seen, just like for Diwali, what happens, people do a lot of furnishing renovations, etc. Like people change the sofas or the sofa couch covers, etc. So through that,
curtains, bedsheets,
people keep it for festivals, because there are so many other people who are related to the trades in those fields. They get benefited. They may not be Christians. They may be of another community altogether, but they get benefited. There are rituals in India which people like to follow so that everybody feels it is festival time.
And to be honest, we don't really see, okay, this person is a Muslim or this person is black,
no,
so I won't buy from
him.
No,
that's not the criteria.
We don't see all that. We just go and buy.
It's the
local
person.
That, oh, this person is Muslim or this person is black, so I won't buy it.
Any shop that is nearest one.
Yeah, okay, if the person looks very evil like Satan, maybe we won't buy from them at Christmas
that
time.
That doesn't happen.
But we don't really discriminate as it happens in the West.
Yeah.
So broadly and so openly,
I wouldn't say
it is shameful.
In the West, but in other countries as well.
Many other countries, even in Asian countries.
Yeah,
to be honest, not just the West, but even in places like Thailand, Vietnam, China.
Yeah.
place. I've personally seen it also in Thailand and Cambodia. A lot of discrimination around festival time.
But you've seen in Mumbai how things go. If it is festival time, whether it is Diwali, Christmas, Eid, everybody is selling their, you know, their share of things. Business is as usual, but business is not the only thing for the festival. The festival is still festival. It is the birth of Jesus Christ, and all Hindus know it, all Muslims will know it, all Parsis will know it, that why Christmas is celebrated, this is the reason behind it. This is the meaning behind it.
Whereas in most other countries, many other countries, they think Christmas is Santa Claus. Maybe the coming of Santa Claus.
Midnight, he will be coming and dropping the gifts. Here, I don't think people waited for Santa Claus. And we don't have chimneys.
And actually, if you reword Santa, it actually spells Satan.
That's what people wrote.
No, I always knew this.
Okay.
So the fact is, even though it may sound very nice, joyous, and a lot of carols revolving around Santa Claus, the fact is, it is actually taking you further away from Christmas than taking you closer to God and Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah. You're actually not welcoming Lord Jesus into your home.
Someone else.
But you're welcoming a total stranger.
I know.
Someone who doesn't matter at all. Someone dressed up as Santa. You know.
In a disguise.
Yeah. So, I mean, it gives me a very sickening feeling when I see the way Christmas is celebrated in the West and even certain Asian countries, apart from India. I've seen it. It's horrible. It's sickening. It's sickening the way it's made all so commercial and it's made all so one-sided. That, you know, you're like an outsider. If you're there as a minority, you're literally made to feel like an outsider on Christmas. So I don't love anything about that aspect.
I think the only thing that saved us from Santa and the tradition of Santa was us not having chimneys, because we don't need one over here. So we don't have the concept of Santa dropping in from the chimney and this and that.
Yeah.
Because we don't have one.
But how ridiculously fake is that itself, you know? I mean, Santa dropping from the chimney. And I mean, children.
It's not a fun thing, but it is not the only thing.
We do believe in it till a particular age.
But adults start believing it is real.
The way it is marketed out there, especially in the West, it's ridiculously shameful. It's ridiculously shameful. The way those things are marketed and not the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But let's hope Norah Jones isn't going to do that. Our daughter of the great Pandit Ravi Shankar.
Yes.
It came upon a midnight clear. Indian connection, possibly. Let's see in the music.
It came upon a midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Still through the cloven skies they come, with peaceful wings unfurled, and still the heavenly music flows over all the weary world. Above its sad and lonely plains, they bend on hovering wings, and oh, its Babel ancient sounds, the blessed angels sing. Oh, you beneath life's crushing load, whose forms are bending low, who toil among the climbing way with painful steps and slow, look now for for glad and golden hours come swiftly on the way. Oh, rest beside the weary road to hear the angels sing.
I would imagine she was pretty close to the mic when she was singing this. The way it sounded, but wow, so clear and so beautiful.
She always sounds good. I like the way she sounds. Maybe you're biased, but I like the way she sounds. I like the way the piano goes along. It's just a relaxing experience when I listen to Norah Jones. I forget about everything else.
Yeah, she's like a breath of fresh air. She's so wonderfully refreshing and so different from all the other artists out there. Mm. You know, she's in a league of her own. Very clearly, even with this rendition, it was kept on one level but done so beautifully. Not too many artists can pull it off. It sounded very...
It is effortless.
I mean, what's special about it, you would say. Mm. But to do it on one level and do it without your voice tearing, cracking at any point of time, so close to the mic, I would imagine. Mm. Wow. Very few singers can pull it off.
And with her...
And she also plays the piano at most times.
With her, there's something that... words don't matter for me. When you're listening... When I'm listening to her, words don't matter. It could be anything. She could be just not... may not mean anything with the words. And still it sounds good. It's that kind of experience.
Hope you guys are having a Merry Christmas and a wonderful time wherever you're joining us from. Yeah. We've been very, very fortunate to have a really, really special year this year on YouTube. More than 33,000 subscribers from close to 200 countries visiting, watching our reactions almost every month. They've been here, most of them. It's incredible. We couldn't have asked for anything more. We're always open, always sincere, always honest in our reviews. We call a spade a spade. We call a rose a rose. We do not know to do it any other way. Our culture, our upbringing has taught us to be exactly the way we are. We understand it's pretty difficult for some of you to digest that kind of honesty and sincerity, because in certain cultures you just aren't allowed to be yourself or just aren't allowed to be open and honest about what you like and what you don't like. We get that. Hence, you have so many people still coming out of the closet as we celebrate Christmas this year. It's prom night for them, literally. And no pun intended, no comparison to the movie Prom Night, which came out recently, starring Meryl Streep and a host of other stars I know.
Is it going to get nominated for Oscars next year?
Stars I know, as in not personally, but
no, I'm saying
stars who have watched a lot of movies.
Almost everything she does should get a nomination at least.
Yeah, I think this year it will be easier for her to get a nomination.
Because there weren't too many people.
Too many big stars weren't working.
Yeah.
Weren't working. They were all hiding. And for good reason.
For good reason.
For good reason. Because most of them come from a couple of countries where they needed to hide most of the time. And it's better to be safe than sorry. Yeah. Even I've not gone out
there. They would set a bad example if they did not do what they did.
But I've not stopped working.
Yeah.
Thankfully, I've had the ability to make it my own year and make it special for all of us. Mm-hmm. And thankfully, it's the best year of my life so far.
That's all for this reaction. Thank you for watching.